Taoiseach, the final debate here in the chamber before the Christmas recess was on statements opposing domestic violence. And that followed an event outside the Dáil here in November the 20th, which was in memory of the 78 women and children who were murdered by their partners or ex-partners. And agencies will tell us that over Christmas, it was the worst in record for domestic violence against women. The word unprecedented was used, and high levels of physical and sexual violence, and many of these events were activities were carried out in front of children. We know it's an ongoing problem in Irish society and that there is a culture of silence around this. Now, I think we accept that in the main, men are the perpetrators, so men are the problem. But I think, and others, I and others believe, that men have to be part of the solution as well. And what I'm doing today is I want to highlight the gaps in services relating to men, for men who are violent and also for men to prevent violent behaviour. And I acknowledge the work of MOVE, Men Overcoming Violence, but there is a need for a dedicated helpline, there is a need for support groups, there is a need for a campaign of awareness that help is available. It's vital that men are encouraged, that men get engaged in this, to acknowledge this abusive behaviour and to try and prevent it. I think we have to be proactive on this. And there will be obvious benefits for the person, for his family, for his community. So I'm asking that there will be a real commitment here, that we start and we look at possibly a pilot programme into this whole area in supporting the work of MOVE, because it's not a nationwide programme. We do have CUSC, we have the Office for the Prevention of Domestic, Sexual and Gender-Based Violence in Ireland, but their work is concentrated on the victims, which services which are very badly needed. But unless we are going to stop the cycle of violence, men have to be involved. And I'm asking that the various departments and CUSC would take this on board and that they would have your support on this.
Thank you, Deputy.
This is an issue that that is of shame in so many cases on our country. And those who inflict domestic violence on women they bring shame on our nation. I've met with a number of these groups, Deputy O'Sullivan. Minister has met with all of the groups recently. Some monies have been allocated directly to groups to deal with this. The Istanbul Convention will be signed and new legislation introduced, and the question of domestic violence is one that is of very high priority for the Gardaí. Having spoken to members of the force myself, and having looked at the call-outs in locations around the country where domestic violence is perpetrated, it's a terrible blight on us, but it is a priority. There will be the Istanbul Convention will be signed. There will be a new package of legislation introduced in regard to this. I take your point about a particular helpline and a support group. Though some monies have been given directly for dealing with this, and there has been a recent meeting of all of the groups involved with a view to getting their views and their proposals on how best to deal with it. So thank you for your question.
Deputy O'Sullivan.
Okay, it is positive that something is moving on this, but signing the Istanbul Convention won't be enough in itself unless there is proactive engagement on preventing this type of violent behaviour, so that it is not acceptable and that those who want help will be able to access that help. We know that it's mainly women who are victims, but there's increasing numbers of men who are suffering domestic violence. And I think there's a particular shame for men, a particular culture of secrecy around men in acknowledging this. And again, we have the organisation Amen who try to support men in this situation. There is nowhere for the abused man and the children to go. Now, we know we don't have enough refuges for women and children, but there's absolutely none for if the person being abused is a man who has the children and has to go somewhere. So what I'm asking is that we will do what we can, regardless of the victim of the gender, that the victim does not have to leave the family home, regardless of whether that victim is the male or the female. Now, there was also extensive research report and a seminar back in December on restorative and transformative possibilities, which are also suggesting that sexual crime could be included in this. It had been felt that sexual crime was not suitable for restorative justice practices. So again, I'm asking that this would be looked at. And I do think that our national office, I would like a response from them on what I've brought up today in relation to male violence, in relation to those men who are abused, and in relation to the victim, that we have to be more proactive, that the victim does not have to leave the family home in these situations.
The matters will be dealt with as crimes. I take your point. Signing a convention doesn't mean that this is going to be dealt with and that it won't happen again. Obviously, all of the groups were invited by the Minister for Justice recently to attend in Dublin Castle to get their views on what programme of action should be put in place, and that's being followed through. Also, the joint Oireachtas Committee on Justice, Defence and Equality will report on the hearings that it held in February of this year following a number of submissions regarding domestic and sexual violence. And the Minister for Justice obviously will take those committee recommendations very seriously, Deputy O'Sullivan, when they're available, and consider them in the context of the proposals that came from Dublin Castle together with the Oireachtas Committee recommendations. And CUSC, the National Office for the Prevention of Domestic, Sexual and Gender-Based Violence, is an executive office of the Department of Justice and Equality, and that's driving the implementation of the national strategy on dealing with domestic, sexual and gender-based violence in the programme for 2010 to 2014. They've commenced a review of that with a view to devising a new strategy, and that will mean new legislation. CUSC's role is to address domestic, sexual and gender-based violence from a number of departments' perspective and endeavours to facilitate coordination across justice, housing, health, education, family support and community sectors. You're well aware of this. So I think the recommendations that come from the Oireachtas Committee and directly from the groups themselves from Dublin Castle will play an important part in the Minister being able to set out a programme for action here. A number of the groups were funded directly from the Department of Justice with a view to information and education and all of that. So hopefully those two entities, the Oireachtas report and the proposals from the groups themselves, will enable the Minister to put in place a programme of action to deal with this, which will be effective. And of course, from a legal point of view, be able to sign the Istanbul Convention, but keep it as a real priority for the Gardaí to implement.